الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. My beloved brothers and sisters, I want to share with you 5 points regarding the first 10 days of the Hijjah. 5 points that you can take on board, inshallah ta'ala. The first point, inshallah ta'ala, is the virtues of the first 10 days of the Hijjah. Al-Imam ibn Majah and Abu Dawood and ibn Majah both narrated in their Sunan on the authority of Abdullah ibn Abbas that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, "Ma min ayyam," there are no days, al-amalu salih, that righteous actions, ahabbu ila Allah, is more beloved to Allah than min hadhihi al-ashr, than these 10 days. The Sahabas were taken back by that statement. They said, "Wal jihadu fi sabilillah," even jihad, O Messenger of Allah. The Messenger said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَلَا الْجِهَادُ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا رَجُلٌ خَرَجَ بِنَفْسِهِ وَمَالِهِ وَلَمْ يَرْجِعْ مِنْ ذَلِكَ بِشَيْءٍ. Except a man who goes to a battlefield and then is killed and he lost all of his wealth, he is better. But other than that, there is nothing better than these 10 days. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he swore by these 10 days. وَالْفَجْرِ وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ. It's narrated authentically from Ibn Abbas, وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ is the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. Also, قوله تعالى وَذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ فِي أَيَّامٍ مَعْدُودَاتٍ. It is narrated that Abdullah ibn Abbas رضي الله تعالى عنه, he said that these 10 days, the ayah is referring to these 10 days, as Bukhari mentioned in his Sahih. The second point that I want to speak about, inshallah تعالى, is fasting the first 8 days of Dhul Hijjah. Fasting the first 8 days of the Hijjah is a sunnah transmitted from the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that we should try to fast these first 8 days of the Hijjah. Point number 3 that I want to inshallah ta'ala talk about is the fasting of the 9th of the Hijjah, which is known as Yawm Arafah. The fasting of Yawm Arafah, as Al-Imam Muslim narrated in his Sahih min Hadith Abi Sa'id al-Khudri, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, "Siyamu yawmi Arafah," the fasting of the day of Arafah, "Ahtasibu ala Allah," I hope from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that it's going to be a kafara for this year and the year to come. Yani this year and the previous year and the year to come. Yani it's going to be a kafara for the year that has passed that the person already did and the year to come. The fourth and final point that I inshallah ta'ala want to mention here is حكم صيام اليوم العاشر. حكم صيام العاشر. Fasting on the 10th day. Fasting on the 10th day is haram and it is not permissible. Abi Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu ta'ala anhu narrated, and it's also found in Sahih Muslim, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam naha Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam عن صيام يوم الفطر ويوم الأضحى. That the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he prohibited on fasting on the 2 Eids in Islam, Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha. Those are 2 days we do not fast. The fifth point that I inshallah ta'ala want to mention is that the remembrance of Allah. وَذُكُرُوا اللَّهَ فِي أَيَّامٍ مَعْدُودَاتٍ. It mentions that we need to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, an increase in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the way that we can remember Allah is by saying La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah, lahul mulk wa lahul hamd wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. And also doing the takbir and the tahmid and the tahleel is what we also should be saying in these days. And our tongues should not be dry from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned to the man who came to him and he said, إِنَّ شَرَائِعَ الْإِسْلَامِ قَدْ كَثُرَتْ. The legislations of Islam have become too much on me. So then tell me, فَأَخْبِرْنِي بِشَيْءٍ أَتَشَبَّثُ بِهِ. Tell me something I can hold on to. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to him, لَا يَزَالُ لِسَانَكَ رَطْبًا مِنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. Do not let your tongue dry from the remembrance of Allah. And Allah mentions in the Quran that remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. Remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a lot so you can attain success. وَلَيْسَ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَقْتٌ مُقَيَّدٌ. Do not restrict yourself in the remembrance of Allah. Remember Him when you're driving, when you're cooking, when you're sitting, when you're laughing. Remember Him in every moment. And that is the sign of the true believer. That is my message to each and every one of you. Anything I might have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are both free from it. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.